Hello, everyone. Frequently, we are faced with generally accepted concepts about a certain image, culture, or even the whole country. Unfortunately, in most cases, these judgments are erroneous, and it's called a stereotype, which is a simplified view of object and phenomena, not derived from one's own experience, but based on indirect perception. The stereotype was described by scientists as a small picture of the world that a person uses in order not to think seriously about anything. Most of these pictures of the world are about religions, relationships, and especially about countries. I live in Uzbekistan, an amazing country. But unfortunately, there are many stereotypes about this country as well as other countries have in the world. What do people usually think about Uzbekistan? All people wear national clothes. Women wear a burqa all the time. Or one of the most famous is that all Uzbek people move from one destination to another only with the help of animals such as donkeys and moose. Yes, there are a lot of thoughts and stereotypes about my country which connected with people and their culture. But today I want to consider some stereotypes which totally have a big influence on the life quality of my country. So let's consider some of them. The most widespread stereotype about my country is that traveling here is really dangerous and quite risky. People often think about Central Asian countries as the object of eternal wars. So where did this hearsay that we have an explosive situation come from? Okay, we all understand that Uzbekistan is surrounded by countries that in the past had some problems with peaceful situation, such as Afghanistan, Tajikistan, and others. But Uzbekistan is not Pakistan or Afghanistan, and not there are no wars, no revolutions, no rebellions, and bullets don't whistle, bombs don't explode. The next stereotype which is connected with dangerous situation in Uzbekistan is that people think that theft is widespread. Neither in Asia, nor in Europe, nor in any other part of the world can be insured against and prison cases of theft, of course. But cases of theft in Uzbekistan are common no more than in other countries of the world. International Center for Public Opinion, Gallup, has published a regular report on the public security global law and order, where Uzbekistan took the fifth place with percentage 91 in this list and was higher than all the Commonwealth of Independent States countries in the world, which means that Uzbekistan is one of the most peaceful and secure countries in the world. The next stereotype is that the Uzbeks speak only Uzbek language and do not understand Russian or English. English and foreign languages are really the strong feature of Uzbek people. Language courses are busied by thousands of young people who wish to learn and then use their abilities abroad. And language courses are full of students who wish to learn English or other languages and then practice and study in European and Western countries. The next stereotype about my country is that people think that there is nowhere to go here, there is nothing to see, it's a boring country and there is no nightlife here. Uzbekistan has its own history, own attractions, own appearance, which certainly deserve attention. Trip to Uzbekistan is a real adventure full of agreeable findings, and here you can dispel your doubts that Uzbekistan is not the most remarkable place in the world. The last one is that the attitude toward tourists is negative. Uzbek people are full of kindness. They are glad to see every guest in their country. Uzbek people are the most hospitable population in the world, I think, and they are glad to see every guest and they can have conversation with everyone. But all these bad notions have a negative impact on my country, on particular on cultural development. Because of such generally accepted notions towards it, many people are reluctant to visit my country, which obviously reduces the quality of tourism and brings Uzbekistan to the low level on an annual visit tourists in the world. Another problem concerning the reluctance of visitors or foreigners to visit my country is some problems with promotional activities here. One of the most famous journalists in Uzbekistan, Nikita Makarenko, wrote a post on a social network about what happens if the word Uzbekistan is entered in YouTube. The quote, "In 2019, you are what YouTube is showing about you. This is especially true for a country as little known abroad as Uzbekistan. It's the truth. We are a little known country." It would seem that there should be different kinds of videos about the most beautiful sides of my country, about people, about culture, but what is in the end? People necessarily look at sites about a country where they are going to go, but the only thing that they can see is something about football and some little known national music. So what tourist can be interested in how some unfamiliar football player runs all over the field and at the end scores a goal? By typing in the search line on the internet official page of Uzbekistan, Wikipedia and a single site without any videos and small numbers of photos immediately appear, which will not be useful for people who would like to learn something about Uzbek culture. Official sites do not give much information about my country. People learn about it only by rumors about it. They believe these rumors. Mass rumors lead to formation of public opinion, and the vast majority of opinions leads to formation of stereotypes. We will create more websites with reliable information because we have a lot to show. This is what every country can say and do, getting rid of unnecessary imposed stereotypes of the environment. As it turns out, stereotypes are viruses which have properties of virus, and they infect healthy consciousness of a person by wrong perception of information. What do we always do with viruses? We try to develop immunity to them and try to avoid complications. Let's do the same with stereotypes. Let's develop immunity to them. Yes, we cannot control the formation of stereotypes, but we can consciously reduce their impact on our behavior. Everything is in our hands. Thank you.